cooking up. Then my windows is tinted as gold. My backseat ain't empty, we just left the Fendi. We getting it all over the place. This is why I need the fam.
What's up, everybody? It's your girl Brittany, and I'm back with another video. If you're new here, welcome. If you're not new here, welcome back. And y'all already know how I give it up and how I get down, okay? So yeah, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, share, all that, and let's get into it. Okay, first I just want to say, I know that I'm saying like I'm DTB and whatnot, but what I'm telling you, we need men in this world. Like, I went to go get an oil change or whatever, and even after that whole process, it's just like, this just seems so tedious. This just seems so, I don't even understand this whole process. So it's just like, oh, you need an oil change, you need this, you need that. It's just like, baby, just give me what I came here for. Thank you. Cause all this other stuff, even this whole oil change thing is going over my head. So just give me what I came here for. And then we can go on about our days. You can send me on my way. We can be good. But yeah, we need men in this world, because I cannot see myself getting under cars or touching cars and just doing kinks to it. Like, it, no, like, no. So moral of the story, men need women and women need men. And reasons like this, like, I just want to be able to pull up, drop something off, the guys fix it properly and give it back to me, and I just say thank you. But yeah, back to why I originally came on here. Am I the only one that didn't know that Nicki Minaj and Megan Thee Stallion had beef to the point where the whole internet was in shambles, and Nicki Minaj went on a rant for the past 15 hours to the point where I love Nicki Minaj. Like, I'm a huge fan, but I had to mute her ass, had to unfollow her ass, because it's just like, what is going on? Where is all this coming from? And then I get on Twitter and I just see her all the way down, like her tweeting, her talking shit, her just doing everything. And I'm just like, okay, in all my decades of supporting Nicki Minaj, I've never ever seen anyone or anything make her this upset, angry. Like, I feel like when her and Cardi B, when they get to their subliminal subtweeting each other, it's like, okay, we know who you're talking about, but she kind of keep it cute to a certain extent, and so does Cardi. It's like, we know they don't really address one another. And I feel like even with this whole Megan thing, like, she didn't come out of nowhere and say at Nicki Minaj, but it's just like, Nicki felt hit and she ranted about it for like 15 hours, and it just kind of threw me for a loop, because I was just like, okay, where's this beef coming from? Like, they did a song together a while ago. I haven't seen them or heard them together, but I really didn't know that they had beef to the point where a homegirl was just in shambles last night. And I was just like, okay, what happened? So apparently, I don't know if this is true, false, or rumored or whatnot, but this is just a story that keeps coming up. Apparently, when Nicki was pregnant, Megan Thee Stallion told her to get an abortion or whatever, and she was liking tweets that were bashing Nicki and blah, blah, blah. And I was just like, one, I didn't know about any of this, and it's just like, two, is tweets the reason why this is going on? I'm saying if somebody that you're supposed to be cool with is talking behind your back, or if they're liking tweets about you, or if someone tells you to get an abortion, it's like, I can see how that would kind of piss somebody off, and depending on the person, how that person might want to cut you off. But that's just the story that I read, because I didn't even read 50 million of Nicki's tweets, because I read the first one, then when I saw that she kept tweeting and tweeting and tweeting, I was just like, okay, I'm over this, I'm done with this situation, because homegirl is just really mad, like she's angry, like she's upset. And then I go and listen to Megan's song, and it's just like, then I get back on Twitter and people are just like, oh, this is shots at Megan, this is shots at Party, this is shots at Drake, this is shots at Rihanna. And I'm just like, what did Rihanna do? I didn't know Megan and Rihanna even knew each other. I can see the shots at Drake because of this whole Drake. I think Drake did bash her when he performed in Houston. And of course, I can see why she bashed Party, because he had dropped that song on her. And then for this whole Nicki thing, like she, like what I'm telling you, I've never seen anyone get her this upset, okay? Like, it honestly just sucks. Like, I like Megan and I like Nicki Minaj. I felt like they made a great song together, and I felt like if they made another song together, that it would be good. Like, it just sucks to see, you know, two of the best female rappers of this time, like, just go at each other's heads like this. But then it's like, I like Megan's song, but then, you know, you get on Instagram and Nicki's doing her song and she said something like Bigfoot or something. It's just like, baby, you really mad, and this is the best you got? Like, I thought she was gonna be talking, you know, just throwing shots. But it's just like, maybe she didn't have no tea on Megan, so she couldn't really, like, you know, throw all that out there. So, you know, this whole Bigfoot thing, I was just like, girl, Nicki, you supposed to be the queen. Your pen game not supposed to play. And the best you can think about when you mad on top of that is Bigfoot? Like, I see why you were getting madder, because it's just like, dang, like she really just ate me up, and I really don't have nothing to say about bringing, I really don't have nothing to say except for bringing up this whole foot thing. So, but yeah, anyways, it's like, I don't understand this beef. I keep hearing about this abortion story, this tweet story, oh, Megan was being a bad friend and blah blah blah, and then it's like she still went to do that song with Cardi and blah blah blah. And it's just like, I know this isn't still going back to Cardi. First of all, why do Cardi and Nicki have beef? Because the last time I checked, it was about this whole motorsport verse. And it's just like, this is how I really feel. This is how I really, really feel. I really wish, I know everybody can't get along, I know everybody's not each other's cup of tea, but the fact that the rap girlies have real, like, beef, and it's really unfolded, it's honestly sad to me, because I really feel like Nicki, Megan, Cardi, Lotto, Ice Spice, everybody, I ain't gonna say that, I feel like everybody is so talented in that they could make great music together. It's like, we don't gotta be cool, we don't gotta kick it, we don't gotta be friends, but let's at least make some money together, at least. But it's just like, all this beef between the rap girlies, they're really catching me off guard, especially if you listen to all of them, because like I said, they could really make good music together. But back to the beef, it's just like, I know this whole Megan and Cardi thing, I really was really hoping they would bury the hatchet by now, because then it's like, you look at their beef and it's just like, oh, Nicki was jealous, or oh, she was liking tweets about my daughter and blah blah blah. And let me just say this, like I said, I love Nicki Minaj, but it really does seem like when certain female rappers come up out of nowhere, they just start having problems with Nicki. And it's just like, I personally, like I said, I don't know what's going on, so I don't know the situation. But from the outside looking in, it's just like, dang, like, I don't want to call her jealous, but at the same time, it's just like, girl, are you mad at something? Like, what is going on? Like, are these girls doing something to you that's really, really triggering you? Because like I said, Megan really, really triggered her. Like, it seems like in that song, she was dissing multiple people, but that whatever she said to Nicki, that shit just really set her off, like, for real. Okay, so I just got back on Twitter just so I just won't be spitting out, you know, me talking my stuff. So apparently in one of Megan's bars, it went over my head. She said something about Megan's Law. And Megan's Law is, you know, something about, you know, being registered as a sex offender in California or something. And as we all know, Nicki Minaj, his husband, you know, he's a registered sex offender. So I can see how that will piss somebody off, for real. But honestly, I really do feel like in the rap beef and whatnot, like putting it in music specifically, you just kind of gotta be ready for that heat. I ain't gonna lie, that bar kind of went over my head. So yeah, if I was Nicki, I'd be mad too, because it's like, but then at the same time, it's like, no offense to Nicki, but it's like, boo, you did marry a registered sex offender. So it's like, you really kind of should have been ready for that bar and kind of just like, yeah, you could have, she, but at the same time, like, you know, I see how that triggered. But at the same time, boo, you did marry a registered sex offender. So, you know, you just gotta be ready for that insult every time somebody wanna come for you, because, you know, that is your life. But yeah, I've really just never seen anyone make her this mad. And it's just like, going back and looking through the song, it's like, okay, she dissed her husband, but I'm not really seeing or hearing the diss specifically at her. And then Nicki brought up on Twitter, she's being hella ignorant, talking about, you know, mocking the fact that Megan Thee Stallion's mother is deceased. And to me, I feel like children and the dead is just, you know, where you cross the line. But I do see people in the comments like, no, like people always do, oh, Nicki just like me, you know, I would have went lower. And it's just like, y'all are just so evil, man. Y'all are just so evil. Like, I feel like she should have left all that out of it. Yeah, but moral of the story, why can't everybody just get along? Like, and then in the midst of this, Ice Spice is trying to diss Lotto. And honestly, let me say this. Y'all know I'm a Clayco girl, so I love Lotto down. When it comes to Ice Spice and her music, I think Ice Spice is gorgeous. She's super pretty. She's thick. And I feel like her music is fun. But Ice Spice said when she came out that she never said that she was an MC. She never said that she was a Nicki Minaj, Lil Wayne, Drake. That she really just make music that she think is cute and fun, and she want people to look at it as if it's cute and fun. So I hear people saying, oh my gosh, this Ice Spice diss was weak. It's just like, what the hell did y'all expect her to do? Like, shorty never said that she knew how to spit. Like, she just said she made music that she think is cute. And that's exactly what her music gives. Like, her music really just gives, like, cute. I guess, like, if you understand, you understand. Like, her music videos give cute and fun. Like, I like, if Ice Spice were to ever be serious, like in rap, and she's spitting bars, like that would be to the point where it's just like, I can't take this serious. Like what happened to Ice Spice? Like, she's supposed to be the cute. But when it came down to the song, okay, let me say this too. I just feel like Ice Spice, her music is cute and it's catchy. Like, regardless if it's good or not, it's catchy. Because if someone else did it that's known to be a rapper, that shit would be trash. And I'm not saying it's not trash, I'm just saying it's catchy. But I just feel like this whole, in the midst of this whole Lotto and Ice Spice thing, I don't even know where that beef came from. Now apparently, this whole Ice Spice and Lotto beef came from, you know, the pose that Ice Spice does, and you know, she's bending over and she has her hand like covering her. Like, it seems like their beef came from that pose, from what I'm reading. It's just like one of them had did it and the other was just like, oh, I did that first. Like, I know y'all are not beefing over a pose. Like, I really thought that this whole Nicki and Ice Spice beef had started from Nicki Minaj. I thought that, I really just thought this was coming from Nicki Minaj. Like, it could have been, you know, sprinkled on top of there afterwards, now that Ice Spice is like team Nicki and Lotto doesn't F with Nicki and Nicki doesn't F with Lotto anymore. But it's just like, I know this whole beef did not start from that pose. Like, I know y'all lying, because after I've been seeing that pose, I really see that pose everywhere to this day. And it's just like, honestly, I know rap beef is supposed to be entertaining and it's supposed to be fun, because I ain't gonna lie, Megan did eat her up and that's why Nicki mad. But it's just like, I honestly just wish the girlies would get along. Like I said, I feel like Nicki, queen of rap, hella talented. Cardi B, hella talented. Even though people like, oh, she don't write her own raps, I feel like her music is enjoyable. Megan, she can freaking rap. And I feel like Megan has the total package. Really, she got the looks, she got the body, she got the bars, she got the music videos. And I feel like Megan, she really is the total package. I feel like Lotto, she got the total package. And I feel like Ice Spice, her music is just catchy and entertaining. So if they were to squash the beef and any one of them do a song with one another, I feel like that shit would blow up. Everybody say Ice Spice can't rap, but it's like, she really did grow a loyal fan base that understands her music and they fuck with it. A lot of people sit there and say, oh, Cardi B and blah blah blah, she can't rap, she don't write her own raps. But she only has one album out, and that shit went diamond. And I feel like if she, even though Bongos wasn't it, no lie, yeah, Bongos wasn't, it didn't do it for me. I thought the video was cute and I also felt like it was catchy. Like, I just wish the girls would bury the hatchet, because all this beef is coming from what? Twitter, he said, she said, poses, who's trying to catch up with who. I just feel like all of this just stems from competition and fans. Like, if social media wasn't a thing and people just release music, nah, I ain't gonna lie, it would probably still be beef. But I really do feel like fans contribute to a lot of beef, because fans get in your head, they talk shit, they mix things up, they add fuel to the fire. Like, if Megan just released this song, nah, that was a diss though, I can't even say that. Because it's like, anytime somebody release a song, like Nicki can make a song and it could be unrelated to this, but somebody gonna find something in that song and be like, oh my gosh, she said blah blah blah, she's talking about Megan. It's just like, girl, I'm sitting here and I'm being mad at my baby daddy right now. Like, ain't nobody worried about that. But it's just like, honestly, it's just a lot. It's crazy. And I'm just so, like, I'm really mind-boggled, baffled at the fact that this beef came out of nowhere. And then on top, I'm just shocked at the fact that Nicki was that mad. Like, I ain't never seen homegirl that mad. Like, she was sitting here on live tweeting nonstop. It's just like, at this point, girl, did your son eat? Like, is he okay? Because you spending all day talking on Twitter. It's just like, you got a whole responsibility in this world, boo. It's like, I hate that for us. I really do hate this for us Barbs, because we like Nicki and we want to support her. But at the same time, we do have to admit that she be on some BS. Like, she really do be on some BS. Like, sometimes she can really come across as bitter, as miserable, as a bully. And this is just from an outside looking in. Like I said, I don't know where this beef stemmed from, but it's like, at the same time, I feel like some people, they don't do things unprovoked. Like, she was provoked, so she did something, but it can just really come off as like, all right, you doing too much. Because bringing up somebody's deceased mother, like, girl, like, relax. Like, all I did was write a song about you. Like, but yeah, y'all, I'm shocked. I'm like baffled. And I really hate the fact that all of this is really unfolding. It's just like, y'all wanna know what I wanna know? Do the male guys, rappers, do they have beef? Cause it's like, it seemed like in the myth, besides this whole everyone saying Gunna's a rat thing. And besides this whole Gunna thing, do the male guys, like, do they have beef? Because it seemed like when the guys make music, they just put out music and it's just like, okay, cool. But it's like when the rap girls put out music, like, people really nitpick and try to find things and make it drama. But I really don't see that with the guys. So it's just like, yeah, so it's just like, this whole situation, in my opinion, it sucks. I feel like we have a whole bunch of beautiful, talented, black female rappers, and the fact that they don't get along and they're dissing each other and it's blah, 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 like, it hurts. It hurts. Because I really do want a Nicki and Cardi song. I do want another Meg and Nicki song. I even want a Lotto and Nicki song. I even want a Lotto and Ice Spice song. But I know we ain't never gonna get it because the girlies can't stop fighting. So it's just like, and like I said, anytime one of them put out music, people just gonna nitpick with the lyrics and try to relate it to some type of beef. And that's just gonna start, something. It's just like, we can't even sit down and enjoy music regardless if it's a diss or not, because somebody gonna make it beef. And it's like, this is why, me personally, this is why, like I said, this is why I don't follow Nicki. This is why I don't follow the Shade Room and all the blogs and stuff, because it's just like, when my artists that I like put out music, I just want to be able to enjoy it. Like, I hate when someone I like puts out music and I get in there on social media and it's just like, oh, this is about blah, 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 blah. It's just like, damn, I just wanted to like the song, and now I'm scared to like the song because all this is going on and I don't even want to spill that hate out my tongue. Because, like, ugh. Because why making it Rihanna got beef? Like, I had, like seriously, like, somebody said, oh, this is about Rihanna and this is about ASAP Rocky. I'm just like, what is going on? It's just like, like, I'm just so confused. Like, I'm sorry. Like, I'm really just shocked right now. But yeah, y'all, that's really all I had to get on here and say. Like, this shit is just wild. It's well, I don't even want to say it's unnecessary, because it's like, nothing was confirmed or denied. All this, it's just crazy to me. I wish it would stop. I understand everybody can't get along and everybody's not everyone's cup of tea. And it's like, okay, if we all lived in a world where everyone got along, then this world would be a perfect place. And yeah, and nothing and nobody's perfect, but yeah. I would at least think people can bury hatchets, or they can make business together and make some money. But it's just like, it just seems like the female rap girls, like, they really just don't get along and they really don't like one another. Like, this is, like, this is hate. Like, this is really real deal hate. And after what Nicki said, she's not gonna be able to come back from that. So it's just like, damn. But yeah, y'all, I just really had to get on here and rant about this, because like I said, this was just too much. And it's just like, I really want somebody to get on here and really just really talk to me like I'm a kid and break this down, like all the rap beef, like the Nicki and Cardi, the Nicki and Megan, the Ice Spice and Lotto, then Megan and Rihanna now. And it's just like, somebody just please just explain it to me so I can understand, because right now I'm not understanding. But yeah, y'all, that's all I have for today. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, share, all that, and make sure y'all give me the deets on this beef, because yeah, I want to know. And I'm not going back and unblocking nobody just to go through their stuff. So yeah, y'all just let me know, because I want to know. Like, yeah, I want to know.
Don't play with it, don't be dishonest. Still not understand.